The nation of America has a hidden history that most people aren't really aware of. There's a lot of conspiracy theories and a lot of ideas, but in reality, America, we have evidence that America, before it was called America, that it was known as this great Western Hemisphere. Okay, the Western Hemisphere, that is what was prophesied by Plato. You had, even the Greek biographer Plutarch talked about voyages to this great land in the ancient world. So really, you got to get past this whole American mindset of Christopher Columbus and the Native American Indians. Governor DeWitt Clinton, former governor of New York, who was also held a prestigious role at the New York Historical Society. And he said on record that they had come into contact with ancient fortifications on our soil. And these fortifications were evidence that there was an advanced civilization far exceeding that of the Native American Indians right here in America. Now, this was on record with DeWitt Clinton. When you consider the fact that the types of news we get today versus the type of news that was, in the early part of this nation, it's totally different. It's all fake news today. All of it. All sides of it that you're going to get on TV. The old news that we found articles. We found all types of information showing that there was an ancient civilization here before the Native Americans, that there was this idea of serpent worship on this continent, and Plato himself, which Plato is a worldwide household name. Everyone knows who Plato is. Major occultist, democratic mindset. They believed that in the end times, there would be a great nation that was going to rise up in the Western Hemisphere. Again, the Western Hemisphere is the key. The great nation of the Western Hemisphere was going to rise up. It's going to take its rightful place as the beacon of light that was going to rule the world. It was going to bring about a philosophic empire, a one-world philosophic empire, and it was going to be utilizing the creeds and the beliefs of the old pagan world. What does that mean in modern terms? It's going to be a resurrection of the old religions, the Babylonian mystery schools, the secret societies, the gods of old, possibly a reference even to the 72 fallen angels. When you start talking about the divine council, that there was going to be a resurrection of these things, a revival of these things, but specifically that this great nation. Now, when you look at the nation of America today, we literally fulfill so much of what the scripture teaches about this great whore of Babylon. And we break all this down in our film specifically so people can see history lined up with scripture. Well, why doesn't America show up in the Bible? Well, we believe it does. But you have to have eyes to see, and you have to have ears to hear. You also have to have a better understanding of this nation, America. Now, let me take you back to some of these ancient views of America. The idea was we were going to be that nation that was going to bring about this democratic commonwealth to the world. Democracy, that was the goal of the ancient philosophers. Democracy was actually an occult view. Now, this might shock some people watching this video, but democracy is an occult view. It's all about bringing together a certain type of system. Now, you start studying the end times, you find out it's a beast system. It's a control grid set up for everyone to be living under one basic ruler. Now, think about this. The Native Americans, we have evidence now that Native Americans that were here, not all of them, but by large, they had secret societies that were literally ancient forms of Freemasonry within their Native American tribes. Satanic rituals, blood rituals. We even have evidence of underground kivas, temples, which I'm sure you're familiar with when you get into the whole Four Corners conspiracy. All these things taking place on American soil. But interestingly, we find out that the God who they revered and worshipped, again, not all of them, but by majority, we're dealing with a serpent god. A plumed, feathered serpent god. The same god shows up in Mexico under the name Quetzalcoatl. You go down into Quiché. In Quiché, they called him Gucamatz. And then in Peru, they called him Amaru. Amaru is the root of the word America. Amaruca literally translates over the land of the plumed serpent. Now, when we get into Ephesians and we understand what spiritual warfare looks like, Paul tells us we're not wrestling with flesh and blood. We're actually wrestling with principalities. Okay, these are fallen angel entities over nations, over land, over different areas. These are the things that affect what goes on underneath. These are fallen, by the way. These are not good entities. These are the higher entities that are in league with Satan. Now, I believe that the plumed serpent god is literally Satan himself. So when you consider that we are living on a land, a massive land in the Western Hemisphere, that the ancients all prophesied was going to be the land that was going to lead the world into a worldwide global democracy, that was going to be a beacon of light bringing about all the old religions and schools of the world. That really makes more sense now that we understand that our nation has been revering and worshiping Lucifer long before the Native Americans got here. They inherited these things from the giants, the white giants that were here before them, the advanced civilizations. And I'll even say this, Sir Francis Bacon, who I believe Francis Bacon was William Shakespeare, he penned the book The New Atlantis. He believed that this land called North America, he believed that this was the site of the original Atlantis. He also believed that this land was going to be fulfilling major prophecies according to what he studied in the occult world, going all the way back to ancient Greece. So, interestingly, when you study the writings of the New Atlantis, you're going to find out that America has been fulfilling these prophecies. I mean, it makes perfect sense. So much so that the occultists, such as Manly P. Hall, you know, who's a major theosophist, by the way, he taught that America was going to be that beacon of light in the last days. He said that this nation was literally going to be shining like a light on a hill. That we were going to shine across the world, and we were going to bring about the democratic commonwealth. We were going to bring about the old religions of the world, the superior ancient knowledge, and that we were going to be that nation that was spoken of by all the old mystics and the prophets of old. Now, part of that is also reviving the Egyptian mystery schools. All of these things have been fulfilled, but here's the thing. The secret societies, they have been maintaining the language, the rituals, the esoteric knowledge, they've been maintaining all of this secretly for thousands of years, passing it on. But they've also suffered persecution over the years. That's why they called them secret societies. They had to go into secrecy. They had to hide these things because they didn't want the common man to understand that. What's interesting about this is that the secret societies that rule America, that founded this nation, we believe that was the reason that they came here under the guise of freedom of religion. See, we've been taught that freedom of religion was all about Christians being able to worship freely. Well, this is a Christian nation, we've been told. Founded by Christians, for Christians, by Christians. You know, I can't think of a greater lie, a greater deception upon this nation other than freedom of religion was for us as Christians. Furthermore, we have come to the conclusion that the freedom of religion was a cloak that would allow all the secret societies to come and operate freely here, and even to set up policy. A lot of the policy that we've seen over the years was set with the mindset of protecting the secret societies, allowing them to get where they need to be, so that they can operate and they can call down the gods of old.